How would you describe your basement, Curt?
My basement is the bunker I wish I had.
Curt La Haise knows what it's like to be caught in an emergency without a plan.
Was evacuated from a wildfire.
That was 35 years ago in California. He used to help people evacuate while working as a police officer.
Understanding why they're not ready, now I could understand that I wasn't ready.
But now living in Wisconsin, that's changed. His basement stockpile shows that he is prepared for almost any threat.
Put the dirty water in and it pumps the clean water out.
He has a 7-month supply of food, a shortwave radio in case cell service is lost, and a fire kit.
And in the event of an evacuation, Kurt's got just about everything that he would need for at least 3 days in this bag, ready to go.
Preparing from personal emergencies to natural disasters to man-made emergencies to, you know, global things like pandemics.
North Korea's missile tests fueling fear.
Kim Jong-un is one of our best salespeople because people are afraid, especially on the West Coast.
Preppers from all over are contacting this survival equipment business in Burlington. The store sends emergency supplies like these water purification systems, medical kits, and these potassium iodide pills that are supposed to protect from radiation.
That's become a very popular. We are actually sold out of it for a month.
Meanwhile, preppers like La Haise like to weigh the odds.
Being a threat analysis, a winter storm, a tornado during tornado season, I think is a higher threat just from where we live to being attacked by Russia or China or any of those.
What would you say to somebody who might be intimidated by your level of preparation?
Don't be. You got to start somewhere, okay? Like I said, start with the documents, start with some food, start with some water, you know, and then go from there.
Practical steps for a peace of mind.
People might watch this and say, that guy's crazy. What's he going to do with all that stuff? Well, like I said, it's a life insurance policy. I'd rather have it and not need it than to need it and not have it.
Well, the American Red Cross has a list of the items that you should consider putting in your emergency preparedness kit. I've got a duffel bag over here with some of the items that they suggest. Definitely a photocopy of your important documents. You also want to have some food that won't spoil easily and a flashlight, among a bunch of other things that are in here. Basically anything that you or your family would need for about 3 days. We've got more information about this list and these kits on our website, wisn.com.